Do you need a tail that stays upright? Want one that's freestanding? Then join me on this second half of this tail-making adventure, making the cover. Before we begin, if you haven't watched part one yet, please check out that video first. What you'll need: the tail base that you made from part one, a sewing machine, plastic wrap, masking or painter's tape, a marker, paper scissors, fur, fabric scissors, pins, needle and thread, electric clipper, mock-up fabric, press studs or snaps, wire, wire snips, pliers, E6000 glue, hook and eyes, felt, and organza. Let's begin. The first thing to do is get a basic pattern. To do this, use plastic wrap and wrap it around the frame. Once that's complete, take long pieces of masking tape and wrap it around the frame on top of the plastic wrap. When it's fully covered, use a marker to mark the placement of the frame. Don't forget to label the pieces. Remove the pattern with paper scissors. It's good to take this moment to check that both the left and the right sides are roughly the same shape and size. Then grab the mock-up fabric and transfer the pattern. You will notice that I'm adding extra allowance for the seams, but also in the center to allow for some shaping so the tail is not flat in between the frame. And of course, cut the pieces out, pin, and sew together. Put the mock-up on the tail base and mark out any alterations necessary, and then make a second mock-up. It was at this point that I decided it was a good idea to add some wire to the base to help with the shaping. So grabbing the wire and the wire snips, cut lengths that can be used to wrap around the base. Use the pliers to help tighten it to the frame and secure it in place with E6000 glue. Side note, if I ever made this again, I would do this as the very first step before doing the plastic wrap to make the pattern. Oh well, live and learn. Chuck on the second mock-up and make sure you're happy with the fit. Once you're happy with how everything is looking, pin and cut out the felt. Then carefully pin the felt onto the organza and cut. You don't have to use organza, just as long as it's something with a weave to help support the felt. I chose organza as it's lightweight. Sew the organza to the felt first, and then pin and sew the side pieces together with a 1.5cm seam allowance. Top stitch the seams down to reduce bulk. Now pin all around the top and to approximately halfway from the tip down towards the opening on the bottom section. And sew, including doing more top stitching. Before turning it right side out, don't forget to clip the point of the tail. Use some hook and eyes to be able to close the bottom around the frame. Slip on the felt layer like a big sock. This is your supporting layer for the fur. Now we move on to the fur. One thing to remember about fur is that the pile is going in a specific direction, so you need to ensure that when laying out your pattern, it all flows towards the point. Turning the fur over, draw out the pattern pieces, then cut them out. The easiest and cleanest way to cut fur is to pierce through the back and run the scissors shallowly along the base. This way, you are not cutting through any excess fur. Next, grab your electric clippers and take off some of the length about 1cm away from the edge, as this will be in the seam. If you don't have clippers, or if you just prefer it, you can use small scissors as an alternative. Once the excess fur has been removed, pin together the pieces and sew with a 1cm seam allowance all over. Remember to leave about half of the bottom section open so the fur layer can be slipped on. Whip stitch the opening sides down about 1cm, then sew in some press studs for closures. The very last thing to do is to sew hooks to the opening of the fur and eyes to the 4 straps on the base. This will hold the fur layer taut against the body. And then there you have it, your own upright, freestanding large tail. As a bit of a note, you can see I wear mine with a corset. This helps support and distribute the weight of the tail. So if you have one, I would highly recommend you wear it with your tail. I hope that you've enjoyed this tutorial and happy cosplaying!